Right, let's create a QR code. So there's two different ways we can create a QR code. Number one, we can add it to an existing design. So if we have a poster or a postcard or a flyer, we want to add a QR code to it. Number two, we can create a QR code, just a standalone code that we might use elsewhere or save to use over again. Now, I'm using Canva today, just a free Canva account. Everything I'm going to do today is free. So let's dive on in, and we'll start by creating a QR code that we add to an existing design. So I'm actually going to just choose one of Canva's templates rather than creating my own design. And I think I will choose this one. So this is a free one. So let's customize this template. Okay, so of course we would go through, we would change all of the wording, the colors, make it our own brand. For this one here, rather than get 50% discount, I'm going to say, leave me a review. Cool. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this whole block here where it says QR code. So I'm going to get rid of that whole block. I think there's a few different elements there that I need to get rid of. There we go. Cool. So now we've got a nice clear space for our QR code. Now we head over on the left-hand side to apps and we do a search for QR code. Now, there's lots of different QR code apps here within Canva. I use just this very first one here. It's literally just called QR code. Very, very simple, easy to use. So I'm going to tap on that one there. Now, the only other thing we need to do before we generate our code is to pop in the URL. So any URL, any web page, website that we pop in there, that is what is people are going to be directed to when they open up the camera app on their device. Hold it over the code, a little bubble pops up and it will be this URL. They tap on it and it takes them directly there. So for this one, I'm going to grab my URL from my Google business listing, the URL that takes people to leave me a review. Now I've got it sitting here in the notepad ready to go. So I'll copy that there and I will pop that into that URL box there. So I've pasted in that URL. Now the only other thing that we need to worry about before we generate our code is if we want to change the color. Now under customize here we have the option to change the background color and the foreground color. We can also change the margin. So you'll see when I generate it there's a little box around the edge and you can change the size of that margin. Now for this I don't need to change the colors, but you might want to make it pink, you might want to make it your brand colors, but I'll leave it as black and white. And then all we need to do is click on generate the code. So that is magically created the code. You can see we've got that little border, the margin around there. We've got the background color is white and the foreground color is black. And we'll leave it like that. But obviously it's in the wrong location, so we can move it around, pop it in there. We can make it bigger or smaller if we choose to. And then when we're ready, we can just download that design. So that's the first way, is where we create a QR code that is embedded into a design. The other way I mentioned is creating a QR code where it is just the code alone. Now I'm going to go back to templates. This time I'm going to choose a blank template. And what I quite like for my QR codes is under social media, if we choose the Instagram post square. Now we click on that one there and that gives us a nice square background. Again, we jump over to apps on the left-hand side here. We search for QR code, and we grab that really simple one there. Now this time what I'm going to use is just my own website. So I'm going to jump into my website. I'm going to take the URL there. I'm going to pop back in and I'm going to enter that one there, paste that in. Now again, we can customize with the background color, the foreground color and the margin, that border around the edge. But otherwise, we just click on generate code. That pops the code in there. And all I do is I just drag it all the way out to the edges there. And then I have just a standalone QR code. So I can download this as a JPEG, keep it on my computer, and then anytime I need a QR code, I've got one to hand. Having said that, this is probably the method that I use the least. I would be far more likely to create something like this that had an embedded QR code in there. But if you get stuck, let me know. Ask away any questions at all, but hopefully that is helpful.